The scientist stands over his creation, waiting for the moment of truth. It's taken him months to collect all the parts, and soon nature will deliver the powerful shock of life. His colleagues said he was mad, but soon they'll all see. The sound of thunder claps overhead, followed by a blast of lightning conducted by the lightning rod directly into his creation. The smoke clears, and the scientist stares at a single destroyed experiment. Okay, not all experiments work out, and some are probably ill-advised in the first place, but a few experiments in human history could have backfired terribly. In fact, everyone's very lucky the 10 experiments in this list went mostly right, because they had the potential to end the world. Number 10. Cola Super Deep Borehole. It was the height of the Cold War in 1970, and the United States and the Soviet Union were each seeking an edge over the rival. Naturally, the Soviet scientists decided to embark on a very practical project, seeing just how deep they could dig into the Earth's crust. Deep underground bunkers were a common strategy in the Cold War, both for storing classified weapons and for hiding in the event of a nuclear war. The Soviets, however, wanted to push the limits, and what they created was the deepest artificial structure in human history, over 40,000 feet below surface level. But that level of deep drilling doesn't come without serious risks. No man-made structure had ever penetrated that deep into Earth's crust, and Russian scientists were worried that it would destabilize the delicate balance of the tectonic plates. Dire predictions were made of massive earthquakes or fractures in the Earth's crust that could cause untold damage. But when the borehole was finished in 1989, there were no obvious negative effects in the surrounding area. It did give Soviet scientists the chance to study plankton fossils never before observed. So, what stopped construction? The extreme heat, reaching 180 degrees Celsius. The Cola Super Deep Borehole didn't destroy the world, but maybe only because of the Earth's natural defense system. Number 9. The Trinity Test. Necessity is the mother of invention, and few things can cause necessity faster than war. World War II was raging in July 1945, and the United States was in an arms race to complete the first nuclear bomb before the Axis powers did. There was no time to waste, as they intended to use the bomb to end the war with Japan as soon as possible. And when the prototype was finished, they were ready to set it off in a deserted area of New Mexico. There was only one problem. No one had ever set off a nuclear bomb before, and there was no way to know what would happen when the atom would split. Could it rip apart the atmosphere itself? Many were nervous, and physicist Enrico Fermi offered to take wagers among the top physicists and military on the project on multiple long-shot disasters that could occur, from destruction of the state to incineration of the entire planet. This briefly caused a panic among the guards, but United States brass decided to go with the assurances of the Manhattan Project's team, and the Trinity nuclear test went off successfully, followed by the only two nuclear bombs ever used in combat, in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Nuclear tests didn't end the world, but the ongoing threat of nuclear weapons nearly did many times in the decades since. Number 8. Starfish Prime. The Cold War and the ensuing arms race led both sides to develop new and more powerful nuclear weapons, to the point where their national stockpiles of nukes far outstrip any other country's decades later. That also meant new and inventive nuclear weapons tests, some of which had scientists deeply worried. As the Cold War combined with the space race, the United States began planning for a possible space war. To that end, they decided to see what would happen if they detonated a nuclear weapon in space, far above the Pacific Ocean. What's the worst that could happen? Only the disruption of Earth's magnetosphere. The bomb chosen for the test, named Starfish Prime, was 100 times more powerful than the bomb detonated over Hiroshima. Scientists worried that it would destroy the layer of the charged particles that serve as Earth's defense system from powerful solar winds, potentially increasing Earth's temperature and radiation levels massively. Despite these warnings, the test went ahead, and while the Earth didn't burn alive, many satellites in orbit were disrupted, and radiation could be detected around the Earth's orbit for years after. Number 7. The Magnaporthe gracia experiments. The food chain is one of the main things keeping human civilization running smoothly. Food production has been industrialized to keep billions of people and livestock fed, and it all hinges on the health of crops. And that's what makes fungi and other blights so dangerous. A plant pathogenic fungus named Magnaporthe gracia has been a plague on rice farmers for a long time, and has been shown to be able to spread to other grains like wheat, rye, and barley. Each year it destroys enough rice to feed 60 million people, and occurs in 85 countries. It's not surprising scientists were studying it, but not all were studying to stop it. There were few weapons the United States didn't look into during the Cold War, but one of the most dangerous was a weaponized form of Magnaporthe gracia. Scientists experimented with turning the fungi into a spray or something that could be distributed via bombs, potentially disrupting an entire country's food system and forcing them to surrender. There's no evidence that these weaponized strains were ever used, but many people have noted that the fungi started spreading faster than ever during this period. Number 6. The oileating bacteria. Not all potentially deadly experiments started out to be weaponized. Some actually started out to heal the planet. It was the 70s, and oil spills were a common event that threatened to devastate the planet. One enterprising scientist, General Electric R&D team member Ananda Chakrabarty, had a unique solution. He would add a plasmid to the chemical makeup of the bacteria Pseudomonas putida that would give it the ability to dissolve organic solvents. That would potentially make it able to dissolve petroleum, making it easier to restore natural environments that were tainted by oil spills. And what could go wrong with a bacteria that eats anything in its path? Many scientists feared that the bacteria would mutate, becoming impossible to contain and eating everything in its sights. Less terrified scientists still warned of its use, saying this powerful genetically engineered bacteria could upset Earth's ecosystem by outcompeting other bacterial organisms. While none of these apocalyptic scenarios came true, it made history in a very different way, becoming the first patented living organism in history when Dr. Chakrabarty won a court case giving him the rights to it. Number 5. Russian underground nuclear tests. It's back to the Cold War, as the Americans and Russians continue to find interesting places to detonate nuclear bombs. As the United States had already covered deep space, it was time for the Russians to go deep underground. It was the tail end of the Cold War, but the militaries were still trying new techniques, which led to 4 underground nuclear weapons tests in the Soviet Union, which were detected by geological surveys. That means humanity managed to create its own earthquakes, as if there weren't enough of those. What's the worst that could happen? Scientists worried about the disruption of the tectonic plates, which could cause massive earthquakes and even disrupt the Earth's electromagnetic field. Of course, that could also have been the purpose of the experiment. That would be a devastating blow to strike against a rival. The 4 tests didn't have any long-term consequences, but the world was so worried about the possible results that they eventually passed a treaty banning the use of military weapons to affect the environment. Number 4. SETI. Not all potentially apocalyptic experiments are military. Some start with peaceful intentions, but things can quickly spiral out of control. The search for extraterrestrial intelligence is a combination of private and government organizations that look for radio waves from deep space that could be evidence of alien life. This not only searches for evidence of existing radio waves, but beams our own radio waves into space, hoping that any alien out there will notice and contact us. But it's like the dog chasing the car. What would it do if it caught it? The world has just barely begun to master space travel, with only one country ever pulling off a manned mission to the moon. If an alien civilization heard our radio waves and had the capability to pay us a visit, they would be much more advanced than us in technology. If they came to visit us in peace and to welcome us to the universe, it might be fine. But if they were a hostile, imperialist civilization, there would be very little we could do to resist it. So SETI might just be putting out a flashing red light for our future conquest. This scary experiment is one that could still wipe human civilization off the map for good any day now. Number 3. Operation Cirrus. Few forces of nature are more dangerous than a hurricane or tsunami. Powerful winds can devastate a major city in a matter of hours, so it was only a matter of time before people decided to find out if they could control these. The original project, Operation Storm Fury, was an attempt to divert the path of hurricanes by seeding them with dry ice. The hope was that this could make it easy to divert hurricanes away from populated areas, but the actual results were far more unpredictable. It turns out nature doesn't like to be messed with. A joint project of General Electric, the U.S. Air Force, the U.S. Army Signal Corps, and the Office of Naval Research, Project Cirrus was launched and seeded a hurricane with 180 pounds of dry ice. It was obvious that the cloud deck seemed modified, but it didn't cause the desired results, as the storm continued its current trajectory into nearby Savannah. One person was killed in the ensuing storm, causing a massive public outcry against the project. The technique of seeding hurricanes was abandoned for years, and the government didn't officially acknowledge the project for years. The science continued to be developed, but seeding hurricanes never proved to be effective. It was far from the only time scientists experimented with controlling the weather, though. During World War II, New Zealand and American scientists worked on developing bombs that would create artificial tsunamis. Number 2. Return of the Black Death. Everyone knows how dangerous a pandemic can be, but no pandemic has ever approached the deadliness of the bubonic plague, better known as the Black Death. It killed as much as 60% of Europe's population in the 14th century before largely fading away. but it's never been exterminated fully, with cases cropping up in animals and people every year. An enhancement in treatments has reduced its fatality rate, but it's unclear what would happen in the event of a mass outbreak. During the Cold War, one country may have tried to do that intentionally. It wasn't until the fall of the Berlin Wall when one of the deadliest experiments in human history was made public. Vladimir Pasechnik, one of the Soviet Union's top scientists at the Soviet All-Union Institute of Ultra-Pure Biological Preparations, revealed that Russia had successfully weaponized the Black Plague in the 1980s. They used a powdered version of the plague, encased it in a polymer capsule, and planned to load it onto warheads that would be equipped with a time release, dusting enemy populations with the worst plague in human history. Thankfully, the end of the Cold War meant it was never weaponized or accidentally released in a lab mishap. But as deadly as these 9 experiments were, none of them had the potential to rip apart the fabric of the universe. Number 1. The Large Hadron Collider. 17 miles below the border of France and Switzerland lies the world's largest and most powerful particle accelerator, built by the European Organization for Nuclear Research. It was built to collide beams of protons at almost the speed of light, letting scientists view particles never before observable by human eyes. The Higgs boson particle was the most famous example, and the collider was able to create miniature black holes in the collisions, giving scientists their first chance to observe some of the universe's most powerful phenomena. Wait, black holes? Those things that consume anything in their path? On Earth? As the Large Hadron Collider ramped up production and testing started in 1998, many began to worry it could accidentally create a black hole that would consume Earth and grow uncontrollably, annihilating everything in its path. Scientists brought in their best teams to show that the black holes disappeared in less than a second and were nothing compared to the ones that occur naturally in space. If no spontaneous black hole in space has consumed us yet, it's unlikely a man-made one is about to. The Large Hadron Collider continues to provide invaluable scientific data, but fears about its safety continue. For more disturbing experiments, check out Science Experiments That Went Horribly Wrong, or watch this video instead.